Hello friends, welcome to Smart News Digital. Today we are going to see the Hindu editorial and news analysis of July 28, 2018. We are going to cover 7 news articles from the Hindu paper which relates both to the prelims and the mains part of the exam. The first article is regarding the Israel and Palestine conflict which has been going on for decades now. The Israel Parliament has tabled a bill which gives exclusive right to determination for the Jews residing in the Israel. This takes away the right to self-determination of the Palestinians, who almost form 1/5 of the population in Israel currently. The bill also makes Jerusalem whole and united capital of Israel. This in context of the recent development of United States President Mr. Trump announcing Jerusalem as the capital of Israel is creating instability in the Arabian Peninsula. Both the opposition party in Israel and also the international fraternity has criticized the bill, calling it racial, unequal, and it's a form of apartheid, dividing the people, polarizing them into two different entities. This bill is also against the two-state solution, which has been expected by both Israel and the world countries as a solution to the Palestine and Israel conflict. Both India and the world nations have always anticipated a two-state solution as a permanent solution to the conflict between the Israel and the Palestine. India has always been a supporter of Palestine in the conflict. For example, we have been supporting to give Palestine a nation status in United Nations Security Council, and also recently India has supported the Palestine gaining access to United Nations Human Rights Commission. On the other hand, the recent development with Israel, for example, our Prime Minister and the President for visiting Israel for the first time, has increased their bilateral ties with Israel as well. Gaining technological support from Israel in the domains of agriculture, space technology and education has increasing the bilateral ties between India and Israel in the current day scenario. So here, the role of India is definitely to act as a mediator to bring So the stability of Israel and Palestine in the Arabian Peninsula will be beneficial for not just India in promoting its bilateral ties and development, but also for the whole Indian fraternity and the population in the Arabian Peninsula. From the prelims perspective, we have to understand where Jerusalem is located in order to understand and answer the map-based questions. Jerusalem is located in the border between Israel and the West Bank, or having Dead Sea on its right side and Mediterranean Sea on its left side. The status of Israel among the international fraternity has been debated for quite some time now. While United Nations has given it an international status, as in the General Assembly Resolution 181, some nations have accepted it and some nations are not towards it. While European Union has accepted it and stands towards it, some other independent nation are not in favor of it. The second news we are going to see today is regarding the lynching and the new law. The incidence of lynching has increased exponentially in recent times. For example, the state of Maharashtra and Tripura has seen almost 30 lynchings in past few months. This had made Supreme Court to call for a special law to deal with the lynching. Until few months, the mob violence was very well organized and targeting the cow traders who were trading the cow meat. However, recently, the mob has taken a different route. The mob violence has become more impulsive and unplanned. This is based on the rumor which is basically spread via the social media like WhatsApp and Facebook. For example, recently there was wrong rumor spreading about child lifters in the state of Maharashtra, due to which few of the Indian citizens were killed by the mob. All these incidences clearly shows the increasing intolerance, the ideological dominance, and also threatening the social order of law existing in our country. This growing polarization is a threat to the Indian democratic ideals of secularism and stability of India. The Supreme Court has given the following guidelines for the state to implement in order to prevent such crisis. Number one is to appoint nodal officers in each district to curb the mobs. The second is to make lynching a separate offence and to give a separate law in order to guide the offence. The third guideline is to regulate social media like internet and the mobile in order to prevent the lynching. So all these measures can bring in the freedom of speech and expression to the personal choices as guaranteed by the Indian Constitution. The third issue we are dealing today is regarding the vote of no confidence for the farmers, which is going to be tabled today in the Lok Sabha. So recently, there has been increasing incidences of farmers' protests due to consecutive droughts experienced in India, and also which has resulted in increased farmers' suicides in states of Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, etc. Let's see what no confidence motion is. No confidence motion can be introduced only in Lok Sabha, and it is admitted to discussion only when minimum of 50 members in the house support the motion. If majority of members of the house vote in favor of the motion, then the motion is deemed to be passed and the government of the current day is bound to resign. The article also discusses about the various arguments in support of the farmers which has led to the current day protest in various places. The agricultural growth rate stood stable for past few years at 1.9% as Economic Survey 2018 shows. Failure to implement the MSP has announced has led the farmers into a distressed situation with regard to both kharif and the rabi crops. And government has also not put forward any separate declaration for drought, and also no improvement has been seen in the ration delivery. Increasing drinking water crisis has also been a recent issue, and farmers is facing the distress because of the lack of irrigational facilities in most of the part of the country. And the recent incidences of regulating the livestock with respect to the cow meat has imposed a ban and cut the alternative source of employment for the farmers. The Diluted Forest Rights Act and other Environmental Forest Conservation Act has affected the Adivasi community, and the Land Acquisition Act of 2013 has affected the farmers in many ways. The next issue is with respect to Fugitive Economic Offenders Bill, which was passed yesterday in the Parliament. First, let's see the provisions with respect to the bill. The first provision is a person is considered as a fugitive economic offender if he has been issued an arrest warrant for a specified economic offence over a limit of 100 crores. And second is if he has left the country and or refuses to come to the country to face the prosecution. This bill comes to prominence in the recent incidents of Nirav Modi and Vijay Mallya, who have fled the country and their refusal to come back to the country to face prosecution. In order to declare a person as a fugitive economic offender, application will be filed in a special court which is constituted under the 2002 Prevention of Money Laundering Act, and the confiscated property and information about the person's whereabouts will be listed there. The special court will require the person to appear at a specified place within the period of 6 weeks, and once the person appears, the charges against him will be terminated. The bill also provisionally authorizes to attach the properties of the person while the case is pending before the special court. Upon declaration as a fugitive economic offender, the properties of the person confiscated rest with the central government. The fugitive economic offender and any company associated with him is barred from filing any civil proceedings in the court. Now let's see the key issues or the analysis of the same bill. Under the bill, as I stated before, a fugitive economic offender is barred from doing any civil claims in any court. So this is against the provisions of Article 21 of our Indian Constitution, which provides right to life. The bill does not require the authorities to obtain search warrants or to ensure the presence of witnesses before the court. Such provision is different from the other provisions in the Code of Criminal Procedure 1973, and this may lead to unwarranted harassment and planting of evidences in some cases. The fifth issue we are going to see is from prelims perspective, India to expand the polar research to Arctic as well. This is very important from the going on climate change and increasing awareness in different parts of the world with respect to the climate change. Recently, the National Center for Antarctic and Ocean Research, which was constituted in the year 1998, has been renamed as National Center for Polar and Ocean Research. India has attained the observer status in the year 2015 within the Arctic Council, which is a forum of countries that decides on managing the resources and the livelihood of people in the Arctic region. India has also set up an underground observatory in Norway, which is called as INARC. This research is very important in the perspective of studying the impact of melting sea ice and also to study monsoon, which impacts the farmers' life in India. India currently has a Himadri research station in Arctic Peninsula under the country Norway, And we also have Dakshin Gangotri, which is currently not operative in the Antarctic region. We also have Maitri and Bharati operating in the Antarctic Peninsula, which are useful to study the oceanographic research about the continental breakup. Next issue with respect to National Green Tribunal, it says no effective steps has been taken to clean Ganga. It also added that the steps taken by the government has only been in paper and the ground reality has not really changed. The National Green Tribunal is a statutory body which has been set up under the National Green Tribunal Act in the year 2010, and it has been established under the constitutional provision of Article 21, which gives right to clean environment as a fundamental right. The aim of the tribunal is to provide fast and effective disposal of cases with respect to protection of environment and also to provide compensation for the affected parties. The tribunal functions under the principle of natural justice and it's not bound by IPC or Code of Criminal Procedure. This tribunal is very important in the perspective of increasing importance given to the principle of sustainable development and the sustainable development goals. The last issue we are seeing today is with respect to BRICS news portal. The decision has been taken in 2018 BRICS Media Forum meeting, which is currently happening in Cape Town, South Africa. The aim is to foster inclusive and just world order. BRICS is an association of five emerging national economies, namely Brazil, Russia, India, China, and South Africa. The BRICS as an institution was formed in the year 2006 and the first meeting was held in the year 2009. In the year 2017, 9th BRICS summit was held in Beijing. The BRICS few declarations associated with BRICS as an institution are Beijing Declaration, Brasilia Declaration, Moscow Declaration and New Delhi Declaration. The New Development Bank is a multilateral development bank constituted and operated by the BRICS states, and it is seen as an alternative to the US-dominated IMF and the World Bank to provide funds to the developing countries for various projects. Thank you.